me start our lecture again on chapter 5, and I'm going to recall you again. We're going to have one problem. It's going to be the cable. And I said the cable is going to be the cable subjected to uniformly distributed load. One of the example is going to be this kind of suspension bridge that you may see in this picture is a golden gauge bridge in California. The bridge is very durable. After many, many thousand earthquake occurring, the bridge still be there. And there are also this kind of suspension bridge in Japan. And also I can show you really huge one in Turkey. And then we're going to have the second midterm examination problem on the arch. And today I did provide you the midterm examination on last year. And that's going to be about the statically determined arch. That means all of this can be solved by using the Fibonacci diagram and the equation of equilibrium. However, there are some special tricks that I like you guys to remember. Last time we talking about the cable subjected uniformly distributed load. It's going to be the same with the cable subjected to the concentrated load. First, the components of horizontal force along the cable is going to be a constant. Okay, and then second, the maximum tension on the cable occur at the cable having highest theta with respect to horizontal right. I note that at the end of our lecture or for the cable subjected to the concentrated load. And these two assumptions will be extended to the cable subjected to uniformly distributed load. And I also add one more, the T-min, the minimum tension will occur at the cable having the lowest theta with respect to the horizontal line. Okay, and now let me move you a bit to this one. The cable subjected to uniformly distributed load is a kind of special cable. And let us take a look at this one. It's a model from the Golden Gate Bridge. Golden Gate Bridge in California. Okay. And following this one, most of the huge bridge built by the cable, by what? By holding the cable from the top of the column of one pier and like it against another top of the column. And most of them usually in symmetry. Okay. And then they just put two cable, one on the left to balance the force on the light blue cable. And again, they put another cable on the light and put it on what's so called really huge abutment foundation. And then the cable system gonna be in equilibrium. Under what? Under application of uniformly distributed force on the bridge deck. And following this one, they assume the uniformly forces on the bridge deck to be W0. Okay. And then following this one, we have the distributed load on this bridge deck also. And then to compute the cable subjected uniform load, we have the cable equation in the form of parabolic equation. Parabolic equation is can be show you in the textbook how we derive the cable equation. And then before you derive the cable equation as the parabolic equation, we set up the point, okay? The point is going to be the lowest point on the cable. I said the lowest point on the cable to be the origin of the X and Y axis. What I should say, based upon this one, if you said the distance you measure from the original to be X, then you have the equation to compute this Y, okay? And then following this kind of concept, the Y is going to be W sub naught divided by 2F sub H and then X square. Now, W sub naught is occur due to a special consideration when this vertical cable link between the bridge deck and the cable, we call this hanger. When the spacing between the hanger is small compared to the total span, then the load that's applied to the bridge deck transfer to the cable in the uniformly distributed load manner. And then following again, as you said, set up the lowest point of the cable to be the origin of the XY axis. And then you can derive this equation. And then following this equation, you know what is Y over here, what is X over here, what is W sub naught, and what's going to be F sub H from the previous slide. Ajahn talking about the component of the horizontal force on the cable. I'm talking about this one, and this one always constant. What is this? It can be the forces that occur over here, okay? Due to the symmetry of this one, okay, the forces occur on point A and occur on point B. This one gonna be T sub A. This one gonna be T sub B due to the symmetry for this special cable, T sub A equal to T sub B. And also this one, you have slope theta sub A. Sorry, you have angle theta sub B, and you will have theta sub A equal to theta sub B also due to the symmetry of the cable. Now, what is F sub H, Ajahn? F sub H is going to be here. It's going to be T sub A cosine theta sub A. And over here, F sub H is going to be T sub B cosine theta sub B, and they are equal. So F sub H is going to be horizontal forces of the cable. Now, let me move over here. We have the cable equation, and in the form again of parabolic equation. Now, the slope that occur over here of what? Of the cable measure from here to be of X and measure from here to be of Y. Then following this one, I said, this is the Y, okay? And this is the X, then over here, you have the slope. The slope can be determined from tan theta equal to dy by dx. Then you do the differentiation of this equation with respect to x of what? W sub naught, a constant, to f sub h, all this one constant. Okay, and then this is going to be x squared. By this one, you will get this equation of what? You take 2 down over here, 2 cut 2, so it's W naught x divided by f sub h. Now, you can determine the equation over here. Again, if you said this is the tension in the cable at the location of x, then the component of this one is going to be t cosine theta, and then it's going to be f sub h. F sub h equal everywhere. Is a constant, okay? And then if you take this one up, this one gonna be t psi theta, okay? That's going to be the vertical component of the tension force at any given point. Now, in conclusion, the horizontal component of the tension force in cable and the cable's reaction, that's going to be this T sub A and T sub B. They all equal to F sub H. And we should say, in general, it's going to be T cosine theta equal to F sub H. Okay, this is going to be T sub A, F sub H, equal to T sub A cosine theta sub A. Over here, F sub H is going to be T sub B cosine theta sub B. All of them are equal. Second one, T max. Again, if you can see what going to be the theta over here. The slope over here is what? It's the minimum point. Slope over here is zero, then theta over here gonna be zero. Theta over here gonna be theta min equal to zero. Then there is the T sub B over here. And also there is the T sub A over here. They are equal, right? They are equal, right? Then this one provide theta sub A, this one provide theta sub B due to the symmetry. They are equal and they are theta max. Now, T max gonna occur typically on the top of the column. But if the cable is unsymmetry, for example, like this one, like you can guess which point gonna have T max. Gonna be the taller column, okay? That's going to have the higher theta and provides T max. Now, based upon this description, if you cut the cable over here, the force that occur over here also F sub H. Now, F sub H going to be the T minimum, and it's gonna occur at the origin of the XY coordinate system. Let me move you to this one. If you go to my hometown, Phetchaburi, you will see this suspension bridge in Gangajan Dam area. Okay, it's a kind of tourist point. If you move across the Nao Si Mountain, you will meet a lot of Kalian people, Karen people over there. Okay, and then in Thailand, have some of this suspension bridge. Bung Ta Lua also have one. If you move to area of Leh, you also have one. But there are really huge suspension bridge. Okay, this show you the efficiency and effectiveness of the cable. There is very huge bridge over here. Have the name of I don't call it Kanakoro Bridge, but 1915 is the year of the independence of Turkey. Okay, and this bridge has the total length of above 4.6 kilometer, and the spacing between these two huge pier columns has the longest span more than 2 kilometer. That's really huge one. Okay, one of the biggest bridge in the world. And this one just finished about 2 years ago. I went there 6 years ago. This is still in construction. Now, what's going to be the problem number one in our second midterm examination? I'm going to have only first determine T max, also T min. Okay. Also, you determine the diameter or the radius of cable. Okay. But typically in the homework, you only determine T max or T min. Okay. That's going to give you what the apply W over here. The second problem gonna be in the opposite way. Now we provide you the maximum tension the cable can sustain. Or sometimes we said that's going to be the allowable tension. Now I'm going to ask you what's going to be the applied force that's allowed to apply to this cable system. Okay. The third, I won't put it in the scope of your examination, but there is example in my PowerPoint. If you interested in, you may study it by yourself. So concentrate on these two types of problem. Now, let me take you guys to the sheet that I provide you. Okay. Many years ago, Ajahn just take the examination in my PowerPoint. This is the same one that you may see in my PowerPoint, and I just put it in the examination. Ajahn just do a bit modification. I increase the uniformly distributed load for this one to be 30 kilonewton per meter. So this one have a larger applied loading, but the geometrics of this cable and the example that we have in the PowerPoint, the same. Okay. Let me show you guys the step that we're going to determine the tensile force at the support A and B. This cable is unsymmetric, so T sub A won't be equal to T sub B, unlike the previous one. And then the problem asks us to determine the minimum tensile force. Okay, and also there are some more additional questions compared to the example in the PowerPoint, trying to determine the tensile force in the hanger. We have the hanger, such as the one you may have out here. This is the hanger. This is the hanger. Hanger used to transfer the applied force from the very stiff girder, stiff girder to the cable. And then they ask you more. They're giving you the allowable tensile stress and then ask you to determine the radius. Okay. This is a typical one that Ajahn may ask you. Okay. Now, following this problem,
what's going to be our first step? Really, first step, you got to talking about the table equation. You got to remember what's going to be the table equation. This is in the form of parabolic, again, equation. And that is going to be y equal to the applied force divided by 2 times components of the horizontal force times x squared. When you put it over here, it's required to you to put the minimum, the lowest point of the cable to be the origin. Let's put this one to be the point of 0, 0. And then we said this is going to be x axis, and this is going to be our y axis. Now, if you move along this one to any given point of x, okay, let's see if you measure from here to be x. If this x, you will get the height over here to be the y, and it's going to follow the equation that I just like it over here. Now, there is what? There is point B over here. Now, if you follow this one, let me move it over here. We have point B. If we move it over here, we have point A. Based upon this equation, we know what? We know this term already. But we still don't know this term. How are we going to determine this term? We're going to solve for the location of this one first. Okay, this one we don't know it yet. We call it x sub b. Okay, and then if you measure from this vertical axis to over here, this is 5 meters. This is x sub b. This is 5 minus x sub b. Now we're talking about the coordinate. Okay, the coordinate. If we're talking about this point, coordinate is 0, 0. If you move along this one, x gonna be x sub b, y is gonna be 3. We have x sub b and 3 meters. Okay, again, if you move to this left side, okay, this is going to be 5 minus x sub b, but it's going to be negative. And then this is going to be negative of 5 minus x sub b. And then you move it up to what? 2 meter. This is going to be the location. Okay, we got to determine the geometric property x sub b first before we can determine the component of the horizontal component of the tangent force. Now, to take the coordinate into this equation, we said at, let's say, a first, at a. When you put it at a, y is gonna be 2, okay? Y is gonna be 2, equal to, this is going to be a constant. Don't put it anywhere, just take it as this one first. They're going to be have the lesson later. And then x squared, even though this is negative, when it's square, this term gonna be, yep, 5 minus x sub b squared. Now, you may rewrite this equation. Just take 2 over 5 minus x sub b squared. It's going to be a constant of w sub naught times 2 f sub h. And then we move to at b over here. We have x equal to x sub b, y equal to 3. So 3 equal to w sub naught times 2 f sub h, and then x sub b square. And then you rewrite this equation again, 3 over x sub b square equal to w sub naught 2 times this one. This is equation number 2. This is equation number 1. And they're going to be equal. Take 1 equal to 2. You have what? You have 2 over 5 minus x sub b square equal to 3 over x sub b square. Now, you have what? You have 2 x sub b square equal to 3 times of what? Of 5 minus x sub b square. Now you got to expand this term. You got to expand this term. And you can expand this term easily. 2x sub b square equal to 3 times of this one, 25, okay, minus this one times coefficient of this one is going to be minus 2, 5 times 1. you know this equation, right? To expand it. Okay, let me take it. It's gonna be 2 times 5 times minus 1. In Thailand, if you have term like a minus b square, it's gonna be a square minus 2ab plus b square. Okay, you may know this one before, right? So again, this one, you will get this one to be minus 10x and then plus x sub b square. Okay. And if you expand it, it's going to be 75 minus 30x plus x 3x sub b square. And now you may move this one, okay, to deduct it. You will get 0 to be equal to 2x sub b square minus 30x sub b. Oop, wrong. It's going to be minus, okay, it's only 1x sub b. And then minus 30x sub b, right? And then plus 75. How to solve this one? Again, you'd have the solution. Let me put it. If you have a x square plus b x minus c equal to 0, you may solve for the x. X equal to minus b plus minus square root of b square minus 4ac. Right, and then over 2a. Okay, over 2a. We have this same equation solution, right, for second degree polynomial. Then solving this one, you have a equal to 1. You have b equal to minus 30. And you have c equal to 75. So x sub b gonna be minus, okay, minus of the minus 30, and then plus minus square root of what? Square root of b square minus 30 square, and then minus 4. What to be a? A is gonna be 1. C is gonna be 75, and then you divide this one by 2a, okay, 2 times 1. You solve it, you will get 2 solutions, and then you should get it to be equal to positive 27 0.248 meter, one solution. And another one, you get 2.753 meter. Now, what's going to be your solution? You got to go back to this picture. What is our largest length in cable system? 5 meter. And then this one is too large. So the solution from this one gonna be 2.753. And Ajahn should put it over here. X sub B equal to 2.753 meter. And this one, 5 minus 2.753. You get what? You get this one, 5 minus 2.753. It's gonna be 2.247. This one, 2.247 meter. Okay. Now you can move on based upon this one, the equation, the cable equation. Now can be written if you determine F sub H. Okay, take this cable equation and then let me rewrite it to a new form of equation. F sub H, take it up, it's gonna be W sub naught divided by 2y. And then x squared, and you said at B, F sub H gonna be this one, 30 kilonewton per meter, and then divided by 2y, divided by 2 times 3 meter, okay, and then time what? Time this one, x time 2.753 meter square. Now meter square, cut this one, the unit gonna be in kilonewton. So f sub h for this one gonna be 37.88 kilo newton. Now we have this one, then therefore the cable equation, the cable equation will be what? This one, y equal to 30 divided by 2 times of the f sub h, time of f sub h, 37.88, and then x squared. Now you should get this equation to be y equal to 0.3960 or x squared. This is going to be our cable equation at x location. Now, if you trying to determine the angle over here of theta, you can do it, right? You just do tan theta equal to dy by dx. You just do the differentiation equation of this one, 0.3960x squared. Now you will get this one to be tan theta equal to 2 times of this one, 0.792x. okay, and then if you like to determine theta, Okay, you may have this one to be x tan of 0.792 x to determine the angle. Okay, the tangential angle, I should say the tangential angle of cable. Now, we need to move on. They ask us to determine the T sub A. Okay, T sub A occur at point A. Again, you start the same one as before at A. At A, you have the X and Y to be what? You have the X to be 2.278. Okay, and Y is 2 meter at A, tan theta A, equal to 792. And then you put this one, 2.247. Okay, and then you solve for theta A is going to be this term, and then 0.792, and then 2.247. You got to get this one to be 60.67 degree. What it means is over here, you get the tangential line, and this is going to be the direction of T sub A, and it has the angle, this theta sub A over there. Okay. Now you can see the horizontal force over here. F sub H is going to be T sub A cosine theta A. Now T sub A is going to be F sub H divided by cosine theta A. Okay, then you have this one to be what? 37.88 kilonewton divided by cosine of 60.67 degree. Then you get T sub A to be 77.33 kilonewton. Anyone may check this one to me? 77.33 is in tension. Okay. And then we move to B at B. Now we determine theta sub B is going to be arc tan 0.792 time x sub B. Okay, 2.753. You put it in your calculator, you're going to get larger angle because the location of B is higher than, vertically higher than the location of A. That's going to be your engineering sense. You should get this one to be 65.36, thank you, degree. Now, you have what? You have the force occur over here. Okay, that's the tangential line, the force follow that. And this is going to be theta sub B. This is going to be T sub B. And the component of this one again is going to be F sub H. And then F sub H over here is going to be T sub B cosine theta sub B. Now, T sub B is going to be this will be F sub H divided by cosine theta sub B. It's going to be very easy. 37.88 kilonewton divided by cosine of 65.36 degree. Okay, and now you have T sub B, 90.86, thank you, kilo Newton. And then you put it over here. This is 90.86 kilonewton in tension. Then they ask us about T min. T minimum occur at the smallest theta, which is 0 degree, and then said at what? At point, I put it over here, at point C. You just give me the reason of that. Okay. Or you may say T min is gonna be F sub H and then cosine 0 degree. Cosine 0 degree is what? 1. So this is gonna be F sub H, and this is gonna be what? 37.88. This is 37.88 kilonewton. Okay, this is going to be 37.88 in tension. Any question? Very simple. Most of the time, my student get full score of this. And this is going to follow the example in the PowerPoint. Now, more must be added on. Let us talking about a given hanger over here. Okay. A given hanger over here gonna take care half of this and half of this for this given loading area. Okay. And what's going to be this spacing? It's gonna be this spacing. So following this one, half to the left and half to the right. Okay, the cable is going to take care of. So spacing of the hanger is going to be what? How determine the spacing of the hanger? How? Calculate how many do you have for the spacing? How many? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. In the total of 5 meter. So you test this is 5 meter divided by 17. You get the spacing to be 0.2941 meter per spacing. Okay. Then the force of the hanger is going to be this one, 0.92941 meter times the loading times 30 kilonewton per meter cut meter. You get this one to be 8.82 kilonewton. So you got to design the hanger with this loading. Okay, I may ask you more on this one. Design the hanger. Every hanger gonna get, no, this one and this one gonna get half of the order. Okay, you know that, right? This to the left and on the right, but most of the time, just put it the same size. how do we need to buy another size, right? Gonna be easier to use the same size. And also, take this one, 8.82 in tension. What's going to be the radius of the hanger was going to be the radius of the cable. Now, we determine the radius. Okay. We determine of the cable. And I should also ask you to determine R of the hanger also. Okay. And then we have T max of what? 90.86 kilonewton. And then we have sigma equal to force divided by the area. And then we have the area we are required. Area take up is going to be T max, and then divided by what? Divided by sigma allowable. And the problem provides us the sigma allowable, right? 125 megapascal. So based upon this one, you just said this is 90.896 newton, and then 125 megapascal is going to be what? 125 newton per square millimeter. Okay, so the result of this one gonna be square millimeter. You should get 726 point. Okay, and I okay, and this is gonna be pi r square. Okay, so r is gonna be 726.9 divided pi, take the square root 15.2 millimeter. Okay, and I should ask you again, the diameter is just 2 times 15.2, it's going to be 30.4 millimeter. Okay, and what's going to be R of the hanger? Let you guys calculate for it. Any question? Okay, no question. That's good. Okay, that's the first problem, right? For the second problem, I may ask you in the opposite one. Okay, provide you the allowable tension force and ask you what's going to be the uniformly distributed load. Let us move to the PowerPoint. Okay, on the PowerPoint, this one, we have the same example. This one, the quite the same one, if you take a look at the dimension, but the W is 12 kilonewton. The one that we just work is 30. Very simple, Ajahn. You just modify the load. Yeah. Don't worry. Okay. You may go to all this one. I should say, by the same geometrics of the cable, you should get the same X. Okay. And then the calculation can go on. Since W sub naught is smaller, so the horizontals gonna be smaller. Previously, we get 37.88, right? This one 15.15. And then we may do the same calculation to obtain T sub B, to obtain T sub A. And then we get T max at point B, since B provide the highest tangent angle with respect to the horizontal line. And then what's going to be T min? You know about it already. And then coming into this one, the same configuration. Okay, just modify the problem, provide you the maximum allowable tensile force for the cable. And then following this one, they ask you to determine the apply uniformly loaded, and then do the same thing. Putting the
lowest point, setting up the coordinate, and this is gonna have 0, 0. Put the same thing. This is x. This is 5 minus x. Do the same thing. Put the coordinate into the equation at b. X over here is x. Over here is 3. So y is 3. X still unknown. And then you may put w sub not in value if you prefer, but it's no gaining for any advantage. For the a over here, you have this one for minus 5 log minus x and 2. Just put y equal to 2. This one 5 minus x square. Do the same calculation. Got the same result. Don't take anyone that's larger than the 5 meter span. And then, is it possible to get solution within 5 meter? No. Okay, for sure. And then you do the same calculation. But this is going to be the unknown. Okay, the unknown. Even you know x and y, just put it over here. Your horizontal force going to be in the form of unknown w sub naught. Now, you got to further your calculation, but this one require a knowledge. What going to be the maximum tension force occur? Again, this one is going to occur at B. From this equation, you have what? The angle that's going to be measured between T sub B and horizontal force. This is going to be theta sub B. And theta sub B is going to be theta max. Now, this is the unknown. Okay, this is the unknown. X is going to be this one. Just take X over here. This one, just take it down here. Okay, put it together. The unknown may eliminate each other. Then you can determine the theta max, the same as the theta sub B. Okay. When you get the theta max, now you use this equation. Okay, you use this equation. Theta max, you know it, right? And then T max, you know about it, right? It's given in the problem. Okay, and then F sub H is in the form of W sub naught. Then you solve this one, you obtain the allowable uniformly distributed load. You get it to be 5.28. Okay. Now, Ajahn come and asking you what is going to be T hanger? What is going to be T sub A? What is going to be T minimum? That's always can ask you. Even asking you for the diameter radius of hanger of cable. So the extra question are required. You guys are supposed to practice this. Okay. That's going to be my second example. For the third type of the problem, again, I ask you to study by yourself. They ask you just to determine the geometric property. Most of the time, we can do the surveying or we can specify the geometric property of the cable. So this one is not quite practical. It's a kind of more theoretical. And we are engineer. We prefer to have more practical problem. And we focus on only the first and second type of the problem, okay? And then, before I move to the arch, we have one more problem over here. Let me take you to our symmetric problem. This structural cable system is symmetric. Okay, I took again the model of the Golden Gate Bridge in this picture. And then it said the steel cable made by the stainless steel support very stiff girder of the suspension bridge. And then the problem said the cable symmetrics about 0.0. That means you may say this is going to be the symmetric axis. Now, the cable have the form from this 0.0. This is going to be 0, 0, and then the cable expand to the light to the top of this point B. Point B over here is pin. Also expand to this one, to the point A. Point A also pin. So at A, we should have components of the force in the horizontal and on the vertical. For this one, for sure, we should have this kind of force to be T sub A. And the component of the force over here will be T sub A cosine theta sub A. When this is going to be theta sub A, and this is going to be equal to F sub H. And over here also, you're going to have, oh, sorry, you're going to have this force to be T sub B, and it's going to have the angle theta sub B over here. We have the component T sub B cosine theta sub B to be F sub H. And again, in the vertical direction, you have this one to be T sub B sine theta. And also over here, you have T sub A sine theta sub A. Then you may say this is going to be the reaction A sub Y. And this can be the reaction B sub Y. Okay, and this one will be B sub X, and this one can be A sub X due to the pin support. Okay, now they ask us the system subjected to uniformly distributed load of 10 kilonewton per meter. Okay, the span length L over here provide to be 100 meter. And they said the sag H, if you prefer, that's going to be the distance from here to here, gonna be 10 meter. Now, following the given size convention, this one will be X axis, and this one will be Y axis. They asked us to determine magnitude of the tensile force in the cable at the horizontal distance X of 30 meter. Coming back over here, if you put it in symmetry, the cable will divide it by half to be 50 meter and 50 meter. Then for the 30 meter, where keep it? Okay, this is about 2.3. Okay, let's say 2.5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then 30 supposed to be 1, 2, close to about here for the distance of
x you measure from here to here and then this is going to be your y okay following this one that we just said x over here gonna be 30 meter now cable equation start with that equation we have y equal to w sub naught divided by 2f sub h and then x squared now due to the symmetry due to the symmetry of the cable okay we have the coordinate of b to b you know the coordinate of b what's going to be the coordinate of b to be what it's going to be here you walk around here that's 50 meter and you walk up about here to be what 10 meter right so that's going to be 50 and 10 meter you know it without any calculation of this coordinate here now we may use this coordinate put it that is 10 equal to 10 kilonewton per meter times 2 f sub h and then x 50 square you get f sub h immediately to be 1250 kilonewton this is the symmetric problem determine of f sub h gonna be very easy since we know the coordinate of the top portion of the top of the cable okay Mo it's okay any question no question let me move you again then over here okay we got to determine the cable equation first so take this one it's going to be 10 divided by 2 1 2 50 and then x squared cut you have this one to be x squared divided by 250 that's going to be your cable equation then we have the angle of cable at a given x so we got to do the differential equation we have tan theta equal to dy by dx you just dip this one by dx of what of x squared minus 250 so you get this one to be what to be x over 125 and then for any theta you have arctan of x over 125 now at any location so coming into our problem our comfort at x equal to 30 at x equal to positive 30 meter okay be aware if I just said as x equal to negative 20 meter just change it okay don't worry you can do so okay so based up on this one you will determine theta right so your theta at x equal 30 meter is going to be arctan 30 divided by 125 put it in your calculator you got it in the degree of what 13.495 degree then over here there is the force okay let me take the portion of this one over here they said free body diagram of the cable portion okay let me take this one take this one we have this portion x equal to 30 meter and we have the cable something like this one okay and we have this is the horizontal component now over here we have the force should be T and then we have this one to be theta at x equal to 30 meter again over here you should know we have the force over here to be F sub H okay and following this one you have series of hanger we have series of hanger we have series of hanger put it over this very rigid portion cockpit okay this is going to be series of hanger just put it over here okay now following this one you have the component of this one to be T cos theta and this one you have this one to be T sin theta right and this one you have W sub naught equal to 10 kilonewton per meter and the distance from here to here is going to be 30 meter. Now, you prefer to have what? Have this one is going to be F sub H. So based upon this one, T from this one is going to be F sub H divided by cosine theta at x equal to 30 meter. So 150 kilonewton divided by cosine 13.495 degree. You will get the tension to be 1285.5 kilonewton. Okay. You have this one in kilonewton. Put it into your area 1285.5 in tension. Okay. If a teacher like to determine what else, okay, now this one is going to be 1285.5 kilonewton. And then this is oops, wrong. Sorry. This is no, this is 1250 kilonewton. This is T 1285.5 kilonewton. And this one is 1250 kilonewton. And following this free body diagram, you can see summation of x sub x equal to 0. And then if you do the summation F sub Y equal to 0, you may have T psi theta equal to this one, 30 kilonewton per meter, sorry, 10 kilonewton per meter times 30 meter, you will have this one to be 300 kilonewton. This is going to be 300 kilonewton. Okay, I can ask you anything on the component of this one. Okay, now we move to what is the magnitude of the minimum tensile force, okay, is going to be equal to min equal to F sub H, and then this is 1 to 50 kilonewton in tension at point O. It's up to at point O. Now, okay. And then you can determine the allowable tensile from the allowable tensile stress. You can determine what? The diameter of the cable. Okay. What is the magnitude of the vertical over here? Okay. Now, on the design, you can do it by yourself. It's going to be 1 to 1 millimeter. Okay. But for 1 point D, you got to determine T sub B first. T sub B first. Do you have T sub B yet? No, T sub A. Sorry. Not T sub B. But they are equal, actually. Actually, they are equal. So, based upon this one, I skip 1 point C. I move to 1 point D dot. Okay. On 1 point D dot, we have what? We have this one. We got to determine the T sub A. Okay. What's going to be our T sub A? Okay, we have T sub A equal to the same as this one, F sub H, and then cosine of theta A. Do you know theta A yet? We don't know theta A yet. Okay, we move over here. Theta A equal to tan minus 1. And then for this one, x is going to be minus 50 divided by 125. Okay, since this one and this one equal, no matter is negative or positive, you will get the theta to be 21.8 degree. Now, your T sub A is going to be 1 to 50 kilonewton. And then you just divide it by cosine of 21.8 degree. You should get this one to be 1346.3 kilonewton. And this one will use again in 1.C to determine diameter of the cable. Okay. And for the vertical direction, T psi theta sub A. Okay, that's going to be A sub Y. And this one is going to be 1346.3 psi 21.8. And then you will get this one to be 500 kilonewton. And I should say that's going to be the area of W over here. You may say due to the symmetry, half of the load over here is going to be 10 times 50, going to be A sub Y due to the symmetry, okay? A sub Y equal to B sub Y equal to 100 meter times 10 kilonewton per meter divided by 2. You're going to get the same result of 500 kilonewton. Okay, but it's going to be 500 kilonewton in vertical direction. Any question? Okay, no question.
Our second session, we come to the arch. The picture shows over here is a two-hinge arch at the Jurajom Gao Royal Military Academy in Nakhon Nayok. They put it in the sports center. and this is the coming for you can see the dimension complete for the military to do the practice, and this kind of arch provide you the high vertical and aesthetic for the building. And for the arch, you may see the structure is vertically curved and it resists the applied load by developing mainly the compression force in the arch itself. Why? Because arch is the levers of the cable. And then talking about parabolic cable. Parabolic cable have the tension in the cable. Then if you reverse back the parabolic cable into the parabolic arch, this arch is special. It only has the compression inside it. Then if you have a chance to travel to the US, especially when you drive from Texas to Arkansas and up to Washington, we have the crossover bridge. We have the main, main bridge over here. And this is, main road over here. And this is going to be the secondary road. So most of the secondary road in the US have the arch, because this kind of arch is one of the most effective and efficiency structure, and the design complete will provide very stable and durable structure. So arch must be rigid, okay, to keep its shape under the compressive force. However, there are some also type of arch, such as circular arch and triangular arch. This kind of two arch not only having the compressive force, it also have the internal shear force and the bending moment. I should note about this one. So we will start our study for the parabolic arch. And I should say, this is going to be statically determined arch. And this kind of arch is going to be what so-called three hinged arch. The name of it, I will talking about this later. It's come the three hinged arch. We can only analysis for some specific type of arch. The arch having two hinges, as the one in the Chula Chom Kao Military Academy, this one we cannot analyze it because due to the reaction that occur in the two hinged arch is 4, more than 3 equation. So we cannot solve it. We going to focus on this three hinged arch. How about fixed arch? This is more indeterminate. This one have 6 unknown and only 3 equations. So this going to have DOI degree of indeterminacy equal to 3. Okay, now we focus on our three hinged arch. However, when we have high arch and then we add the internal hinge into it, when we have internal hinge for the tie arch, the arch going to be statically determined. Now, our focus may expand to tie arch also. Let me put you to some more example. This show you the Roskirch Bridge in Bern, Switzerland. This is the, one of the tie hinge arch. And if you see the point over here and the top of the arch, we call it the crown, okay? And then this is going to be the internal hinge and make it to be statically determinate as. Then this is statically indeterminate as I mentioned before. There are pin support over here. You can see this kind of support is the pin. So under the applied force, there are three reaction. Ajahn, if I put a hinge over here, okay, a hinge over here, should it be statically determinate? Yes, if you put the top or any point to be hinged, this one will change to be statically determinate touch. Sorry, didn't ask. Now, there are various tasks in this world, most of them usually statically indeterminate, such as this punch bit in England. This one in Hua Lumpur in Bangkok, also statically indeterminate as, okay? And there are various indeterminate as. We're going to focus to T-hing as or Thai as with internal hinge. And then our life going to be a bit easy. As is a kind of ancient structure. People use as structure since Roman Empire, and this one is one of the aqueduct used to transfer the water from one area to another one area in southern France, and that's controlled the environment for thousands of years. That's proof that ash are very durable structure. And there are some beautiful ash in the form of triangular. So we have what? We have three hinges ash, right? We have what? We have Thai ash with internal hinge, okay? And this is another one that should put on the triangular arch. Most of triangular arch has the pin support here. And over here, you may assume this one as the hinge. So we should have this kind of triangular arch with internal hinge in our consideration also. So the scope of the problem gonna be all of this, okay? Now, let me take you to the tunnel. Some of you guys may prefer to work as the engineer in the tunnel. And actually, our geotechnical engineering graduate work in many areas in Laos to build tunnel, to build dam in Laos. And this one also in China. Let me take you to the model of a T-hing arch, and we concentrate the T-hing arch subjected to uniformly distributed load. And then I said, it's going to be the levers of the cable subjected to uniformly distributed load. This arch have a parabolic shape, okay? And then under the uniformly distributed load, it receives the load by developing only the internal compressive forces. And that's why they use a lot in small bridge in the US on the secondary road. It is the levers of the cable, okay, subjected to distributed load that have the internal tensile force. Now, when you build this one, for the cable, you got to have the anchor. For the arch, you got to provide the column transferring the force from the bridge deck to the arch structure. The spacing between the column must be very small, okay, compared to the total span, in order to assume the load applied to the arch in the form of uniformly distributed load. Then, following this kind of concept, the us will subjected to uniformly distributed load. Under the load W that's applied to this structure, and the us has pin. So what you will know, we have the reaction to be A sub X and A sub Y over here, and also B sub X and B sub Y over here. We have the total of 4 reactions. That's impossible to determine all of the reaction, and that's why we got to separate the free body diagram. And let me make a discussion on this one. For the parabolic arch, I should say, when we talking about the cable, we put the origin of the coordinate at the lowest point. But for the arch, we put the origin to the top or to the crown of the arch. Now, what we have is we got to measure the x distance from the left to the right to be positive. So based upon this one, we will have this one to be the arch equation. Y now is going to be negative something. Okay, I will talking about the arch equation. Okay, following some discussion later. Okay, let me put this one. We will have the arch equation later. Let me move to different types of arch for the parabolic arch subjected to uniformly distributed. This one only subjected to the compression. For the author, the arch will subjected to normal force, shear force, and bending moment. So if we have these two types of arch, most of the time, Ajahn will ask you to determine the bending moment also. For the thing arch, as I said, we have 4 reactions. So in the analysis of this one, we got to separate the arch into 2 portions. And then we have this one for A sub X, this one for A sub Y, this one for B sub X, and this one for B sub Y. And at the hinge, we have this C sub X and C sub Y. Due to the third law of Newton, you have this one for C sub X and this one for C sub Y. You have the total of 6 unknown. And it can be so, since you have 2 free body diagram, and each of the free body diagram have 3 equations, so you have 6 equation. The problem is which equation you are going to use first. Summation of the moment equal to 0, summation of x sub x equal to 0, or summation of f sub y equal to 0. Typically, we take the moment at point A, okay? And then after that, you can write the equation in the form of C sub X and C sub Y. Then you take the moment again at point B. You get another equation in the form of C sub X and C sub Y. So, and then you got to solve the equation to get the internal forces at the hinge. After you get the C sub X and C sub Y, then later you may use the summation of X sub X equal to 0 and F sub Y equal to 0 to determine A sub X and A sub Y respectively. The same. Use F sub X equal to 0 to determine B sub X. Use F sub Y equal to 0 to determine B sub Y respectively. Now, coming into this one, Ajahn mentioned about the arch equation that's in a parabolic shape. Okay. This one, they said the main structure of the bridge is a teak arch with parabolic arch. Then follow what we have discussed, the origin of the reference axis will put at the top of the arch. And then this one will put in the X axis. And this one gonna be the Y axis. Then if you said you measure the X distance from the origin, like this one, we say X, then the location on the arch over here, we will say this is going to be the Y. Y is going to be the function of the X over here. And then the form of the function is going to relate the height of the arch. This is going to be H. H is going to be the vertical distance from the crown to the support. Okay, and then divided by the half of span, we have this one for the L. Now, following this equation, we have Y equal to minus 12.5 times 25 square, and then X square. So you can determine every location on this teaching arch, okay, by specify X up on this equation, you will get the vertical coordinate. And I should say again, this is negative. Now, the arch is in symmetry also, okay? And for the equation of the arch, you may determine the slope. This is going to be tan theta. What is going to be what? This is going to be the tangential angle of that point with respect to the horizontal axis. And I should say this is going to be the angle theta. Now, why is important? Because when we talking about the angle over here, so if you cut this one, okay, and you draw a portion of the free body diagram of this arch, okay, and then you may need to understand some more important thing. Over here, you will get the force the same as this one, C sub X. And this one gonna be the force of C sub Y. And then there is the angle of tangential light over here. When you dark it, you got to get this kind of tangential light. And then this is not good. Let me illustrate this one. Let me put it again. And then the angle between the yellow line and this one gonna be theta, and also this is theta. The forces develop in this body first is gonna be the force over here. That is going to be the normal force. That's gonna act perpendicular to your cut point. Okay, and then you can see this end has the angle theta over here. And you also has the shear force, okay? The shear force gonna be in this direction. And again, if you take this vertical line, this is going to be the theta. And the last one for the free body diagram of this kind of body, you will get the moment over here. That's why we got to determine the angle theta between the tangential line yellow with the horizontal line. Then you have dy by dx. You diff this one, x square. You get this one, and you have this one for determine the angle theta later. Let's take this one. You have this one. Don't later. You have the reaction. Since this one is symmetry, you may say due to the symmetry, we have C sub y equal to A sub y equal to 10 kilonewton per meter. And this one gonna be time 50 meter. So, and then divided by 2. So this is 500 divided by 2. It's gonna be 250 kilonewton for A sub y and for C sub y. Or you may say, let me take the moment over here. You will get C sub y to be 250. And also, if you take summation of x sub y equal to 0, you get this A sub y to be 250. Since you get this one and this one, you still need the C sub x and C sub y. You select one of the segment of the arch. Okay. If you do draw the free body diagram of the light segment at B, is the hinge, okay? There is B, there are B sub X and B sub Y at the hinge. And based on this one, you have three unknown. You better to take the moment at point B to eliminate B sub X and B sub Y. And then to determine C sub X, okay? C sub X rotate in this direction, so this direction is positive. C sub x times this 12.5, and then you have this resultant force 10 times 25. The moment arm between this point and this point gonna be 25 divided by 2, and rotate in this same direction, positive, okay? And then we have this force that's gonna rotate in opposite direction. This 250 gonna rotate in this opposite direction, and you have this is 25 meter foot kit. You get C sub X to be 250. Now, use summation of the force to be 0. This one, B sub X, gonna be equal to C sub X. And how about summation of F sub Y, B sub Y positive plus this one, and it's going to be equal to this one, you get B sub Y equal to 0. This again, due to the symmetries of the loading and the structure. Okay, if the load is not symmetry, B sub Y won't be 0. Note is important. Note, okay? This one is 0 only for the symmetric load and symmetric structure. If the load is not symmetric, if I said there is only one size of the uniformly distributed load, I just cut half of that out, okay? The structure will need more calculation. Okay, now let me cut it over here. Okay, depend on what you love to use. Now, they just provide only the free body diagram in this portion. And again, I should say they cut it. When they cut it, they should cut it, okay, in the direction like this one. They didn't cut it only on this one. Then, as I said, there is the theta over here, and there is the theta over here. I don't say it again, okay? And then there is the normal force, shear force, and moment, and then what we have is we got to determine the internal forces and moment at this x location. Now, following this free body diagram, if you take the moment at point D, eliminate v sub d and n sub d, you will get this one to be positive. What you have is you have this force also to be 10x. Okay, the line of action is here. The rotation is in the same of m sub d. This one time x over 2. So after you put this one, these two term plus to each other. But 250 kilonewton have the line of action over here, and it's rotated in the opposite direction, minus 250. The distance from here to here is this one. Okay, just take the arch equation and put it over here. And then if you arrange it, this is gonna be 5 and then x square. Cut this one, cut this one, minus 5x square. And then m sub d gonna be 0. And this one provide your guide parabolic arch subjected to uniformly distributed load has no bending moment. Now, let me move to summation of the force. And following this one, we have this one n sub d cot theta. Okay, this in the opposite direction, so this term gonna be negative. For v sub d, project it over here. This gonna be v sub d sine theta, and then this one also negative. Okay, and this one is positive. So we have positive 250, negative v sub d sine theta, negative n sub d cosine theta. Don't worry, Ajahn will provide you with the location, so actually you can determine the theta. Okay, and then this the first equation. Second, summation of f sub y equal to 0, and I should say this is gonna be n sub d sine theta upward. So this is positive. And this is gonna be v sub d and then cosine theta. And then this gonna be negative. So the v sub d provide negative. N sub d provide positive. 10x negative. Really like the second equation. If this is in the form of equation, the solution of this one going to be very tough. But if this one is in angle theta, such as 21.8 degree, okay, you can solve for v sub d and n sub d easily. Okay, now, to solve this one, you got to go back to the triangle over here. Okay, take this triangle, and then we have this angle to be what you measure in this direction, and the angle theta over here, this is going to be your x, actually, and this is going to be your x, and this is going to be your 25. This is going to be square root 25 square plus x square. You get this one. For the sine theta, x divided by this one, okay? And then for the cosine theta, 25 divided by this one. And then you put everything up into this equation. You use the Mathematica program. You use the MATLAB, MATCAD, those kind of symbolic analysis program. You get the solution. And the solution said, no shear force occur in that section. Only the axial force occur on it. And then you may plot the graph. And I should say the point over here provide the maximum compressive force as the support. Again, cable have the maximum tension and the support. The arch also have the maximum compression and the support. Now, you have this one as the maximum force. And then you can decide the arch, use that compressive force. There are also type of arch, okay? And I got to let you guys study about it, okay? This one is special due to the asymmetric loading. This one, asymmetric loading. And due to the asymmetric loading, you got to take the moment over here, get equation number one, and then you take the moment over here, okay? And then you have the second equation. Now, you saw the equation, you got B sub X and B sub Y. Now, when you know B sub X and B sub Y, use the summation of the force determine A sub X and A sub Y. And also, you should use the summation of force in X and Y direction to determine C sub X and C sub Y. Then, Ajahn may ask more from this one. What is going to be the maximum force in the arch? Sure, it's going to occur at the support. And compare the light blue support and compare to the green support, which one going to provide the largest compressive force, resultant force? The light blue, because this one is 7475 due to the asymmetric loading. And then I should ask you again, based on the thrust analysis, can you determine the force over here? Can determine the force over here if Ajahn provide the angle here to be 60 degrees? Very simple. Just use the method of Joyce. Okay, you can analyze it. And then let me finish this one, the Thai arch. Okay, the Thai arch is a special arch. It's going to have the internal hinge over here in order to be able to analyze it. Since this is pin and this is roller, you guys can determine the reaction easily. Follow the concept we learned from engine statics. Take moment at point A. Okay. And then you have C sub Y times the distance from here to here of 5.5. And then we have this one in this rotation. Take this one as the positive. Now, we have 15 kilonewton putting in this opposite direction with the moment arm of 0.5. And also, we have this one put the rotation in the opposite direction with the distance from here to here to be 4.5, you get C sub Y. And then summation of X sub X equal to 0 easy. And then summation of F sub Y, you get A sub Y. Now, you can see, you have the force over here. You have the force over here, okay? So this is internal hinge. You may cut it over here. Over here, it's going to be B sub X and B sub Y, right? And then we have the tension in the height also. You have three unknown again. Take moment at point B, okay? And then you will have what? He going to rotate in this direction with the moment arm of 2 meters. So this is positive. And then about this one, we have 15 kilonewton, and that is going to be time to rotate in the same direction. However, we have the reaction putting in this direction with the moment, with the moment arm of 2.5 in the negative direction, you get the T. Then I may ask you, what's going to be the diameter and radius of the pilot? I may ask you that. Okay, you may decide it. And then for B sub X and B sub Y, you can determine it. And I should say, you're going to have R sub B. From the R sub B, you should be able to decide the pin. Okay, at this point, if the pin is double shear, okay, double shear, and then Ajahn said how allow is 100 megapascal, then what's going to be D sub B or R sub B? For this one, Ajahn may provide you with the sigma allow to be 125 megapascal, and then you should be able to decide the size of the tight. Okay, then you may assume the arch to be parabolic tight arch. That means the top gonna be the origin of the equation, and this is gonna be the y. Okay, following this one, this is going to be y to be h. Okay, and I should say this is gonna be L, if you prefer to consider this one. And then following this one, let's put the coordinate, okay, coordinate of the pointy, okay. The measure from here to here is 2 meters, okay. And if this is 2 meters, you can compute for the distance y2 from here to here. And then you get this one to be minus 2 for the x2. And this light blue minus 1.25. After that, you may draw the free body diagram of this portion. Okay, of this portion. For this portion, you will have this one for 0.5, okay, meter. And you will have this one for what? For 2 minus 1.28. Okay, and you may draw the free body diagram of this one, since this one could be 0.72 millimeter. Put the A sub X and A sub Y. A sub X is 0. Oop, A sub Y. A sub X is 0. A sub X is 0. And this A sub Y. And this tight force. Then, at the cut point, you have the normal force. You have the shear force. You have the bending moment. Can you determine the theta? Sure. You can determine the theta. Just dip this one. Okay. Change to this one. Put the x2 equal to 2 meters, you get the angle. Since this is 52 degrees, this one is going to be theta also. Okay, now we go back to the first example of the arch. Determine the moment M, determine the shear V sub D and N sub D. And that's going to be the finish of our second problem in our midterm examination. Let me start by consider this example. Okay. I should move to what we discussed. There are two types of arches we are interested in this course. We discussed about the parabolic arch already. Now, let me move to discuss about the circular arch. This circular arch subjected to 2 kilonewton first ทูลยองท่าน permit her first transfer from the top girder okay and let assume the column is close to each other so this uniformly distributed load will act on the arch as we assume in this chapter then this arch has the radius of 8.9 meter so what we supposed to have since this one has 8.9 meter so if you measure this is about 2 3 meter 3 centimeter for 8 meter so it's going to be proportion for this one is let's say 30 millimeter you have this one 30 millimeter you have 8 meter so you have 8 meter for 30 millimeter for 8.9 millimeter it's going to be 8.9 times 3 divided by 8 that is a little bit larger than 33 8.9 times 30 divided by 8 33.4 so about 33.4 that is 30 about this point so this supposed to be the center of the arch and by doing that that is going to be 3.33.375 millimeter so this is going to be the center of the circular arch now this is going to be 8.9 meter and also this is going to be 8.9 meter and based upon what we have over here there supposed to be c sub y and c sub x over here okay this is going to be pin support a sub y and then a sub x a sub x a sub y are required to determine and also you got to determine the force at the hinge b sub x and b sub y now the problem said the origin of the referent Cartesian coordinate xy start at point a so based upon this you got to understand the referent axis for this one is going to be x here and then again it's going to be y here so like the previous discussion for parabolic arch you guys supposed to understand the shape of the structure first and then we will determine the reaction at the support A and the hinge joint B that is going to be 6 point and what is the max magnitude of the maximum compressive force so what is going to be the magnitude of the compressive force occur on this arch and then they ask us to determine the moment at point D which is 3 meter from the point A and has 2.363 meter in the y direction let us work step by step first what we may consider we have 4 unknown reaction so we supposed to what separate the arch into 2 portion let me put it in the format like this measure this one this is 3 and this is going to be 1.7 let me put this one that is going to be 3 okay this is going to be let's say move it a little bit here this is going to be 3 and this is going to be 1.7, and then you may sketch the shape of the arch to be like this. Okay, this is going to be the A B portion, and since the arch is symmetry, if you may notice, this is going to be the symmetric axis. So by doing this, you may has this one again for 3 centimeter, and then you may get the shape of the arch to be approximately like this. And under the action of the force, let me put the force on the arch in okay this manner. And what we put it over here is going to be 2 kilonewton per meter. Again, in this portion also we have the uniformly distributed load at concrete, 2 kiloton per meter. And what's going to be the distance? Okay, the arch has 4 reactions. Okay, thus we must separate the arch into 2 segments. Let's say it's going to be A B and what? And B C. Then we draw the free body diagrams as shown. Okay, we draw it over here. Under this one again, we have this one as A sub Y. We have this one as A sub X, and then based upon we discussed here, the force that acts at B, let me assume is going to be in the B sub Y direction to resist the vertical force, and this one must be B sub X. And based upon the Newton third law, this is going to be B sub X. And then this is upward. This is going to be downward, B sub Y. Now, we also have this one as the C sub Y and this one as C sub X. Okay, so from the free body diagram, okay, we have 6 unknown. And then which are equal to the number of equation of equilibrium. And based upon this, we put the dimension, and this is going to be 8 meter. 3 + 5, and this is going to be 5 meter, and over here, due to the symmetry, is 8 meter. And which free body diagram, which one you gonna start first? Let us consider the free body diagram of A, B. And by doing this, usually we just do the summation, okay, again, at A equal to 0 to draw the equation of B sub X and B sub Y. And later, we take the moment at point C, we will get another equation in the form of B sub X and B sub Y. We will solve it later, okay? Based upon this concept, take a moment over here.
And then what we have B sub X and B sub Y. Both of them gonna rotate in this direction. And B sub X is in this line of action, which is 5 meters from A. So the moment is gonna be 5B sub X. The B sub Y has 8 meters different. The line of action of B sub Y is 8 meters from A. So it's gonna be 8B sub Y. And then the 2 kilonewton meter going to have the resultant of 2 times 8. That is gonna be 16. And its line of action has 4 meters from point A. So you may put it in minus, or you may put it into equal to 2 times 8 and 2 times 4. Okay, this is going to be the equation of B sub X and B sub Y. Again, if you consider the free body diagram of B, C. Now, you again take moment at point C, summation of the moment at C equal to 0. Now what you have is B sub X has this line of action and 5 meters from here. So 5B sub X and B sub Y is 8 meters from C, and it's going to rotate in the opposite direction, minus 8B sub Y. And finally, we have this one. And this is again 2 times 8. And the line of action is 4 meters. And it's going to be 2 times 8 times 4. You have this one for the second equation. And you have this one for the first equation. You solve the equation, you will get B sub X equal to 0. No. Yes, B sub X is 12.8 kilonewton and B sub Y equal to 0 kilonewton. And based on this, what you have, this is 0. And can we have B sub X of 12.8 kilonewton. Now, they require us to only determine the A sub X and A sub Y. You may consider this one, summation of X sub X equal to 0. The B sub X is 12.8 kilonewton. So basis upon this one, A sub X, okay, equal to 12.8 kilonewton. So you get this one to be 12.8 kilonewton. This one 12.8. And if you summation of F sub Y equal to 0, upward is positive, you get A sub Y. And then the B sub Y over here is 0. This is 0. And you have this one to be 2 times 8. So A sub Y is gonna be 16 kilometer. Sorry, kilonewton. We have this one, 16 kilonewton. And if you go to this size, you may use the summation of X sub X equal to 0. Now, this is positive. C sub X is gonna be 12.8. kilonewton. And then if you do the summation of F sub Y equal to 0, this one is 0, right? So this upward is positive. C sub Y is going to be 16 kilonewton. And you can see A sub Y and C sub Y is 16 kilonewton. Why? Because the arch is in symmetry. So the answer must be correct. That's why they didn't ask us to determine the C sub Y. Since C sub y is equal to A sub y. Again, C sub x also equal to A sub x. So they just ask us to determine A sub x and A sub y. And then B sub x and B sub y. The C sub x and C sub y, they know me, the Ajahn know is going to be equal. So I didn't ask you to determine it. And then what is going to be the maximum compressive force that occur in the arch? And most of the time, the maximum compressive force occur at the support. Okay. So maximum compressive force usually is occur, okay, is occur at the support. And the support A and C, A and C, the support, they have the same reaction in the vertical and in the horizontal. So it occur at the support A and C. Okay, you may put it like this. And then you may say R sub A equal to R sub C equal to the square root of 12.8 square plus 16 square. By putting this, you get this one to be 20.49 kilo Newton. So this is going to be 20.49 kilo Newton as the maximum compressive force that occur over here and over here. And if you consider this one, let's say A sub X is 12.8. If you put it, this one is the point A and it's going to be 12.8, and this is going to be the A sub X, 12.8 kilonewton. And this one is 16 kilonewton. Put it into the 16 millimeter, okay, by scaling at 16 kilometer kilonewton. And then when you go back to the ending static, okay, you will use the parallelogram law, and then you may draw this one. This is going to be R sub A. Okay, this is going to be R sub A. And you also can use this one to design the pin at support A and C. Okay, you also use this one to design the arch, okay, at A and C. You can get the reaction. One important thing I like to tell you is how you determine the angle over here. Let's say this is going to be theta sub A. So tan theta sub A is going to be 16.12 divided by 12.8. So the angle of theta sub A, you can find it to be 51.3 degree. Okay, and also it's going to be equal to the angle theta sub T with respect to the horizontal line. Okay, the same thing, you have this one. And then if you dock it, that means this is going to be R sub A, and this is theta sub A, and this is going to be what we have, R sub C, and this is going to be theta sub C, like that. And the moment over here, the pin the pin is going to be zero. Okay, now if you would like to determine the last one, the internal bending at point D, okay, at the coordinate here, that means we got to draw the free body diagram. We let's put this one separate kit, okay, draw the free body diagram of AD. Basis on this, you may project it, okay? And then what is this? It's going to be 1.1 centimeter, and this is about 1 centimeter. Let's say this is going to be, well, this is going to be a little bit smaller, okay? And then this is the portion of the arch, and then this is going to be A, and this is going to be D. And based on what we obtain, A sub Y is going to be 16 kilonewton, and the A sub X is going to be 12.8 kilonewton, and the distance over here is going to be 2.363 meter, and this one is 3 meter. And based upon this, for sure the structure will subjected to uniformly distributed load of 2 kilonewton per meter transmit to this column and this column. Now at this section, they're supposed to has the, actually this one, if you project it from the previous one, it's going to be 34. If you recall, that's about 34, and this is going to be the center. Again, this is also going to be cut at point O, okay, at point O over here. And at that point, you supposed to have the bending moment. And let me put the M sub D in this direction. This is going to be M sub D. And again, we also may have this one as the N sub D, and this one as the V sub D. So based upon what we are looking for, summation, if we take the moment at point D and use this one as positive, M sub D can be determined easily. Okay, M sub D, and this one is going to be 3 times 2, and the distance here gonna be half of this, so plus 3 times 2. And then what we have, 3 times 2 is going to be 6, and the distance here is 1.5, rotate in the same direction. And we also has this one rotate in the same direction, it's going to be 12.8. the distance here is going to be 2.363 in this direction. And then 16 is going to have the opposite direction with the distance of 3 meter. By doing this, if you put everything together, the M sub D is going to be 8.75 kilonewton meter. Okay, it's not that hard to determine it. And to determine the N sub D and V sub D, actually we may need to determine the angle, okay? And if you did some geometric analysis, and let's say the angle that's we have for this one, you may use the scale and do the measurement. And let's assume this one to be 40 degree. If this one is 40 degree, you may also may know that this one also to be 40 degree. And based up on this, if I'm zooming in, we assume the angle over here for 40 degree, we may determine the N sub D and V sub D like this. First one, we will have the summation of X sub X equal to zero. By putting this one, let's say this one will has, let me use the pencil. Where is my pencil? The N sub D, when you project it, it's going to be in this direction. This one will be N sub D cosine 40 degree. And then we will have this one to be N sub D and sine 40 degree. Okay. And in the similar manner, the V sub D in this one is going to be V sub D cosine 40 degree. And in this direction, this one will be V sub D sine 40 degree. When you do the summation like this, let's say putting this one in the positive. So V sub D sine 40 degree in this direction. And this one is one to be negative N sub D cosine 40 degree. And then this one is good equal to 12.8 kilo Newton. That is going to be our first, second, third equation. And then for the last one, summation of F sub Y equal to zero. Let's put up what is positive. So V sub D over here is downward minus V sub D cosine 40 degree. And then N sub D also downward. So minus N sub D and sine 40 degree. And this one, the resultant of this is going to be 2 times 3 is going to be 6. It's going to be downward, right? It's going to be minus 6. And then 16 is going to be upward. So you may plus this is going to be 16. Or if you make it equal, this is going to be negative. And this is going to be, this is positive. This is going to be negative. Okay. And then you may get this one to be what? Minus 10. And since they are minus, 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 you may change it to plus, plus, plus. Okay. And then you have this one for equation number 4. And if you so, the simultaneous equation, okay, you will have N sub D equal to 16.23 kilonewton and V sub D equal to minus 0.57 kilonewton. So V sub D going to have equal to 0.57 kilonewton. Having this direction. This is one of the previous examination, the problem in the arch, the second problem in our second midterm examination. Okay, now let me move to another one. This arch is symmetric arch. When it is symmetric arch, A sub Y and C sub Y, they are equal. Okay? And also, the A sub X and C sub X, they are equal. And due to the symmetry, most of the time, the B sub Y is equal to zero. Okay? You may check this one with the first example of our parabolic arch. Now, let me move to the unsymmetric arch. Unsymmetric arch, let's say this is unsymmetric arch, because even though the arch itself is symmetry, they are the same as the previous one. But the problem now subjected to various types of point load over here. The problem is the load on the left and load on the right, they are not equal. Now, they ask us to determine the A sub Y, B sub X, B sub Y as the previous one. And now you may notice the A sub Y and C sub Y that occur over here, they will not equal as the previous one. And then again, from the previous example, we have the total of four reactions. We cannot solve this arch by only three equations of equilibrium basis upon what we has previously. We may again draw the free body diagram of these two portions. This is B and A. And again, this portion, this is going to be C and B. Now, the load act on this one, this is 2, 2, 2. The total of this is 8. So you may see this is 2 meters. So you got to measure this one. Okay. If it's going to be 28 millimeter, you may divide it into 4 portions. 28 divided by 4, that is about 7 millimeter each. So just put this one over here, and 7, 14, 21, okay, and then you get this. So basis on this, we have this one transfer directly into point A. This is 4 kilonewton, and this one is going to be 8 kilonewton, and this one again is going to be 8 kilonewton, and this one is going to be 4 kilonewton. Now we consider the second one. We may do the same thing, okay? And we put it for 28 millimeter, so 7, and then 14, 21, and about this one, 28, the force that's X over here is 3 kilonewton, and over here is going to be 3 kilonewton, and this one and this one 6 kilonewton and 6 kilonewton, and you may put this one for 2 meter, 2 meter, 2 meter, and 2 meter again. We draw what we have for the reaction: A sub Y, C sub Y, and C sub X. And this one is going to be A sub X. Now you may consider the point B, and let me put this one for B sub X. and this one for B sub Y and downward over here. Based upon this, we have the distance measure over here for 5 meters and also this here for 5 meters. Again, you do the same thing. Take the moment at A and at C, you will get one equation of B sub X and B sub Y and another equation of what? Of C sub X and C sub Y. Okay. And then there is a place that we got to draw the whole free body diagram of the arch. Oh, you may put the force something like this. Okay. And then basis up on basis up on the free body diagram of the arch. We again have, we have 4 reactions and cannot determine or find by using 3 equations of equilibrium. You put the same thing that we discussed before. Thus we need to separate the arch into 2 segments and draw the free body diagrams of them. Okay, as show. Okay, and then if you give this lesson now, you are legal to go next. You use the free body diagram of A, B. Now, what do? We take the summation of the moment at A equal to 0. Based upon that, what we have is the term B sub Y. Okay, now the B sub Y rotate in counterclockwise direction. B sub Y has this one for 8 meters. Okay, from the line of action to point A. So 8 times B sub Y. And also we have B sub X rotate in the same direction. And B sub X is going to be the line of action of B sub X is going to be 5 meters from point A. So 5 B sub X. And now what you have is the 8 kilonewton, 4 kilonewton. It's going to be in the opposite direction. This one produce 0 moment. And 8, the life action is here, time 2 plus 8. The life of action from A is 4. And plus 4, the life of action going to be 6. Okay, and if you put them together, 8 times 4, 8 times, okay, 16 plus 32. Plus 24, that is going to be 72. And this is going to be equation number 1. Now, we go to the free body diagram of BC. Okay, this portion. And if you like to complete it, put 2 columns like this. And take the moment over here. Let me put it summation of the moment about C equal to 0. Now, this one is going to be B sub Y. Now, B sub Y going to rotate in this direction. And all of this going to be in the same direction of B sub Y. So, B sub Y has this one is 8 meter from C, 8 B sub Y. And then you may see the B sub X now rotate in the opposite direction. This is 5 meter. This is 5 B sub X. Okay. Ajahn may just change this one, may move this one from C over here, maybe this one. If I move this one like this and I just change the problem to be something like this, okay, we're going to get another problem, and the free body diagram of this portion BC will be different from AB also. But in this manner, just put them together as it is. So just put this one, and then it's going to be negative. Okay, 3 times 6. Okay, it's going to be, this is plus 3 times 6 is in the same direction of the moment of B sub Y, plus 6 times 4, and plus 6 times 2, and then equal to 0. And if you like it again, it's going to be 8 B sub Y minus 5 B sub X, and you put it together, it's going to be negative 54. You get this one for the second one. You saw 1 and 2, okay, and then you must get B sub X equal to 12.60 kilonewton, and B sub Y equal to 1.125 kilonewton. Now you put this one, 12.60 kilonewton, and this one is 1.125 kilonewton. So B sub X is 12.6 kilonewton, and B sub Y is 1.125 kilonewton. So this unsymmetric arch will have the value of B sub Y. Unlike the previous one, the B sub Y is 0 due to the symmetry of the arch. Okay, I would like to point this one to you guys. And then we will use the summation, it's up to you, summation of X sub X equal to 0. So A sub X in this direction is going to be equal to 12.6. So A sub X is going to be 12.6 kilonewton. If you do the summation of F sub Y equal to 0, upward is positive. So A sub Y is upward. And you have this one plus 1.125, and then it's going to equal to 8 times 3. This one is 8. Okay. So if you put everything together, you may get A sub Y equal to 22.875 kilonewton. This is going to be A sub Y of 22.875. This is 22.875 kilonewton. And again, you may find R sub A if you prefer. Okay, based upon this one, the A sub X is 12.6 kilonewton. A sub Y is 22.875 kilonewton. So if you like, you may determine this one, which is going to be the R sub A. Okay. And then R sub A will be equal to 12.6 square plus 22.875 square. All you get is going to be 26.12 kilonewton. Okay, even though they didn't ask you, but if you like to decide the pin, you got to compare the resultant force between R sub C and R sub A. Now, summation of X sub X equal to zero. The C sub X is over here. Just put this one is positive. And then it's going to be equal to 12.6 kilonewton. And you may notice the horizontal component of the reaction by the symmetry of the shape of the arch. Okay, it's symmetric shape arch. The C sub X equal to C sub Y. Now, summation of F sub Y equal to zero. Upward is positive, so C sub Y is upward. The 1.125, 3, 3, 6, 6, all of them are downward. So that is going to be 3.6+6+3+1.125. The C sub Y is going to be 19.125 kilonewton. And you can see this time R sub C will be smaller than R sub A. It's going to be 12.6 square plus 19.125 square. If you put everything together, this is going to be 22.90, okay, kilo Newton. When you compare this, see, the maximum reaction is occur at A. So if you decide a pin, you may use 26.12, and then you put the same pin at the C. It's also a support C. It's also will be safe. Okay, now let me put a little bit more. Okay, we will next go to determine the axial force, okay, and the internal bending moment, shear, axial force, shear force, and bending moment at point D. Okay, it said it's 3 meter and 3 meter from here, and it has the tangential line at point D of 45 degree. Okay, let me put this one. The maximum compressive force is going to be 26.12 kilonewton, and C sub Y that we have is 19.125. This is 19.125 kilonewton. Okay, let us do the same as we have before by finding the force and reaction at point D. We do the projection of this one, and then the portion of AD is going to be something like this. That is A and D. And then basis up on this, you have this one, 3 meter. This is 3 meter. And then A sub X is going to be 12.6 kilonewton, and A sub Y is going to be 22.875 kilonewton. That is the reaction. And then you also have the 4 kilonewton and 8 kilonewton. So just draw the column and put the force. This is 4 kilonewton. This is going to be 8 kilonewton. And since this is 3 meter, so this is going to be 1 meter. This is going to be 2 meter. And based upon what we have, we're going to have the N sub D over here. And also this one, V sub D over here. And we also have this one for M sub D. Again, since the tangential angle, okay, that is going to be this line act with horizontal. This is going to be 45 degree. If this is 45 degree, this one also 45 degree. We going to determine the internal axial force, internal shear force, and let us start by taking the moment at point D to eliminate N sub D and V sub D. Okay, and then this direction is positive. So you take moment over here and M sub D, putting this one is positive. So this one going to rotate in the same direction as the M sub D plus 8 times 1. And this one also going to be 3 meter plus 4 times 3. And this one going to rotate plus 12.6 times 3. And this one in opposite direction, you may say minus 22.875. And the line of action over here is going to be time 3 equal to 0. If you put everything like this, your M sub D going to be 10.825 kilonewton meter. Okay. And then it's going to rotate counterclockwise 10.825 kilonewton meter in this direction. And then you're going to do the same thing. You got to project N sub D into the horizontal. This is N sub D cosine 45 degree. And this one, N sub D sine 45 degree. And if you project this one going to be V sub D cosine 45 degree. And this one is the opposite, V sub D sine 45 degree. You do the same thing as before, do the summation of X sub X, summation of X sub X equal to 0. Okay. And let's put N sub D is in positive. So we have this one, N sub D cosine 45 degree. And this one is in opposite, V sub D sine 45 degree. And we have this one, okay? It's supposed to be 12.6. It's in the opposite to the sine convention. So this is going to be equal to 12.6. And it's going to be equation number one. Now, summation of F sub Y equal to 0. Let's put downward is positive. So N sub D here is downward. N sub D sine 45 degree. V sub D over here plus V sub D cosine 45 degree. And the force over here is going to be in the downward direction, and that is going to be, if you put it, it's going to be plus, and if you move it, it's going to be negative. Okay, it's negative 12, and then this one in the opposite direction, so it's plus 22.875. Now, if you combine them together, this is going to be 10.875, the second equation. When you solve this equation properly, so you will get N sub D equal to 16.60 kilonewton. That is going to be in this direction. And again, V sub D is minus 1.22 kilonewton. It's going to be equal to 1.22 kilonewton in this direction. So You just put this one V sub D is going to be 1.22 kilonewton in this direction, and this is going to be 16.60 kilonewton in this direction. This is another or previous examination, and there are also examples. Most of my example, I took it from my problem in the examination. You may watch my video clips and trying to solve this kind of problem by yourself to do a lot of practice to get or to gain more skill on the analysis of the arch. So this is going to be the second problem for our second examination.